Illustrator video shows how you would save multiple artboards to a PDF. And the reason why you would use this PDF, it's for sharing with a creative team that isn't using Illustrator, maybe with a client, or submitting your project through Google Classroom or eCampus. All right, so you can see here, we have our artboard icon, right? It looks like a piece of paper with crop marks, and there are three different artboards. We also have up our artboards window panel, which you can show or hide by going to window, artboards, checking that on or off. You can change the order of your artboards by dragging or using the arrows in this panel. So, most likely, I've intended that I want my PDF to have artboard 2 as my first page, artboard 1 as my second page, and artboard 3 as my third page. If I were to save as a PDF right now, the order would go 1, 2, 3, right? So my artboards are counted as pages. So first I'm gonna get this in order. So I can do that by dragging over here 2 to 1. Right, drag it above. Now I can zoom out and you can see my order is 1, 2, 3. All right, I can also move order by using these arrows. Okay. You can change the name of your artboards by double clicking on the words. So we'll say this is third, second, first. Zooming out, command subtract or minus. You can move around your artboard. If you have your black arrow, the selection tool, if you hold down the space bar, it turns it to a hand. You can drag around your Illustrator. All right, so file, save a copy. This is how we're going to take our Illustrator document and make a shareable PDF. So we're going to save it to our desktop. You can see the name is up at the top. Don't put spaces in your names. AI's Adobe Illustrator format. We're going to come to the bottom, say format PDF. You can see it changes there. Go ahead and say save. You can see you have a selection for all or range of pages. Save. Okay, so this is the important box. Up here, preserve Illustrator editing capabilities. This is going to make your file larger and let you open your PDF in Illustrator. That's not necessary because this is just sharing your document. So you can unclick that and instead click optimize for fast web view. You have other options over on the left about adding trim marks, additional compression, marks and bleeds for printing. This is really just sharing our file. So we're just gonna stay in the general and say save PDF. We get this pop-up that if we don't have Preserve Illustrator editing capabilities, then you might not have some features if you try to open this in Illustrator. We're not trying to use this as our editable file. That's our AI file that we're saving. So we can say okay. All right, so this is Adobe Acrobat. And you can see that I now have three pages. Page 1, and we can see this is page 1, compare. Page 2, the circles, and page 3, the rectangle. And I can also look at my page thumbnails and see that order. All right, so that's how you use the file, save a copy, to go ahead and make a PDF that you can then share with others who do not have Illustrator.